Towards the time of the preacher.
I used to be such a nice guy.
Well, for a man that don't go heels, you run your mouth kind of reckless, don't you?
It is a little too early for being that loud. Hey, too late.
What an incredible Cinderella story. This unknown comes out of nowhere.
I guess I'm the only one that remains unaffiliated.
Welcome to the 4-1 Podcast, where for 4 minutes, I talk about one topic. Right now, I want to talk to you about one of my favorite topics, worship. You see, as a pastor of a church, we have weekly worship services. Most churches do, really just about every church I know of does. The thing is that many churches, though, don't really know why they have worship services. Now, our church is a little different because we do have a clearly defined philosophy of worship. We know what we're doing when we gather together. You see, we try to create a space and an atmosphere where we can remove as many distractions as we possibly can, because we do live in a very distracting world. I mean, there's all kinds of things that are vying for our attention and our affection. They're trying to captivate us and draw us into them. But then there's this God, this creator, the all-knowing, all-seeing, all-powerful creator of the universe, who longs for us to connect with him, to be captivated by him, to be drawn into him and caught up in his presence and to respond to him. And so when we gather together for a worship service, that's what we want to do. We want to minimize the distractions and create an environment where people can experience the presence of God. You see, there's really nothing special about any building we might choose to worship in. Like, people like to call it the sanctuary, or my personal pet peeve, the Lord's house. What a goofy thing to say. That building you go to is not the Lord's house. Oh my goodness, what a lie. I mean, honestly, it's just a lie. That is not the Lord's house. That's just a building, for goodness sake. You're the Lord's house. If you have a relationship with God, you are a temple of his Holy Spirit, and he dwells inside of you, and he's saying, hey, I want you to be aware of my presence. You see, that's the thing. I mean, the earth is the Lord's and everything in it. He is everywhere at every time. He's in every place. He's present. The big issue is that we miss him. We don't see him. We don't encounter him, often because we're not looking for him. And so that's what's special about these worship gatherings. We come together for the purpose of encountering God and to do it in community. And it's powerful. When a group of people encounter God's presence and respond to him, then we are able to encourage one another, to inspire one another, to cheer each other on, to raise our voices and really not even be self-conscious about it. That's what's great about large crowds. A big crowd of people gathering together to say, ah, God, there you are, and to respond to him. You see, that's our philosophy of worship. We want to create a space that minimizes distractions so that we can all be aware of God's presence and then respond to him appropriately. You see, the appropriate response to God's presence is to be in awe. Ah, oh, God, look at you. You are so great. You are so powerful. And ah, look at me. I'm not. Ah, but you choose to see me and allow me to connect to you and to be a part of your family. Ah, you see, there's this awestruck wonder, and then also an aha, where we say, there you are, God, and here I am, God, and we're together, and we're not alone in this. And the best part of all, my favorite part, is that God is revealed through the worship of his people. You know, when you gather together with other people and you exalt God, he's revealed through that, and there will be others there who may encounter him for the very first time. That's what's happening when we get together for worship. And you know what? That'll help you as you pray for one, asking God every day, give me one person to share your love with. Keep praying for one and worship your full head off.